My name is Daniel Krauss. I write books for Random House that are released as young adult, but very upper edge young adult, so they're also pitched towards adults. My first book was The Monster Variations, but I guess for this short talk, I'll talk about the current one, which is Rotters, which is about a boy who goes to live with a father who he has never met, who turns out to be a modern-day grave robber, and makes his living robbing graves, and this boy becomes part of that underground world. There's a whole underground society of this that stretches back to the 1800s. It has its own codes and its own honors. And then my new book is Scowler, which comes out in March, which I don't have a short pitch memorized for. But it's about a farm family that lives on a dying farm, and the father, who's sort of this sociopath father, gets out of jail and comes back to the farm. And so the son is forced to resurrect these three imaginary friends he had as a child that were toys of his. One of them was a teddy bear named Mr. Farrington, and one was this plastic Jesus figure named Jesus Christ, and one was this little troll named Scowler. And he has to bring them back to help defend his family against this psychotic man. There's a deep, rich history of grave robbing throughout the world. In fact, when I started working on Rotters, I established a Google alert for grave robbing. And every week, I would get some grave robbing incident in America. So it's still going on. Not in the numbers it did in the 1800s, but it's still happening. The idea came to me 10, 15 years ago. I worked in TV. I worked for NBC as a news photographer. And I was in North Carolina, and I was in a news van, and I was driving away from a hurricane, which is what you want to do when there's a hurricane, right? And I passed a cemetery, and the cemetery was flooding over to the point where I could see, you know, caskets about to come out. And I had this image in my head of men sort of fighting through the muck, trying to get something valuable that was in one of those caskets. And it's such a great gothic image. And it stuck with me for 10 years until I finally figured out a way into the story, you know? This is a tough question, because there's so many like positive messages you can get. And there's one message that, it sounds really defeatist, but I'm borrowing it from an author friend of mine who's much more famous than I am. And the piece of advice is, God, I feel terrible saying this. The piece of advice is be talented, which is a terrible thing to say. But stacked against all the you can do it, follow your dreams thing, it doesn't hurt to have a tiny bit of pragmatism in that, you know, you're going to be competing against a lot of people, you know. So talent is something to have, and it's something you can grow and foster, but it's also something that's hard to come upon if it's... Just you have to be realistic sometimes in following your dreams. You can follow your dreams, but it gets to a point as if you're living on the street and you're 60, maybe you weren't meant to become a javelin thrower or something. There's at some point you have to accept your physical or artistic or mental abilities, which is a terrible answer, but that's the best I can.